Barakat Yahweh Shah. First and foremost, I'd like to give infinity honors to our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shah, and double honors to the apostles of GMS, starting from Apostle Taha, Apostle Gabar, Apostle Aramla, Apostle Bakar, and Apostle Manatazak, and all the other Akim out there pushing this word in truth out in sincerity. And salutations to the elect. This is the Akaral Kalkahan from the Light of the Gentiles camp. And I just want to do a small little segment called Did Esdras See IUIC in the Vision? Now, the reason I'm entitling this video that is for the simple fact that the idea came to me from reading 2nd Esdras, the second chapter, specifically the 47th verse, but we're going to start from verse 43. And now, as I go along with this short segment, I want you guys to really think and to really put yourself in that mindset and say, at this point in time, did Esdras happen to see IUIC in the vision? And for all you brothers out there that know who IUIC is, you know that the ringleader of their camp is called Nate, or as we like to call him, Nate Satan. Now, I'm going to read this scripture, and once I read it, then we're going to elaborate a little more on the situation that's going on. Or should I say real quick that if any of you are real familiar with IUIC in their camp, they're basically, as I would say, they're basically a bunch of demons. And the reason I would say that is because they continue countless times, you know, day and night, and refuse to acknowledge the name of the Lord, the Heavenly Father, and His Son's name, which the Heavenly Father's name is Yahweh, and the Son's name is Yahweh Shah. And to be saved and to have salvation and to be part of the elect, you need to know that name. There is no other name under the heavens that will give you salvation besides Yahweh Wah Yahweh Shah. And this camp and countless other camps out there that do the work and will of Satan continues to take away the name, or try to take away the name from Israel and profess the name of Yahweh Wah Yahweh Shah. And Nate is definitely a top demon in doing that. But we're going to read the scripture real quick. But we're going to start from 2nd Esdras 2 and 43. Matter of fact, let's start at 42. It says, I, Esdras, saw upon the Mount Sinai a great people whom I could not number. That great people is talking about the elect of Israel, the 144,000. And they all praised the Lord with songs. Verse 43. And in the midst of them, there was a young man of a high stature, taller than all the rest. Now this person that Ezra is seeing in his vision, that he's describing, is Yahweh Shah, who this world so ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. It says, and upon every one of their heads, he set crowns, which even to stop right there for a second is, you know, it's nothing more honorable in the universe. I'm not going to say in the world because it's talking galactic now. I'm going to say in the universe, it says that he is going to set crowns on their head. That means individually he will walk up to every person that's part of the elect and set crowns, which is, you know, the most honor, the biggest honor anyone could have. It says, and was more exalted, as he should be more exalted, because he was the one that died on the cross and suffered for our sins and died for our sins. And also, basically, mainly, when you understand it, died for the elect, that they may be saved. Because if he didn't, we would be in his captivity for eternity. It says, which I marveled at greatly. Verse 44, so I asked the angel and said, sir, what are these? Verse 45, he answered and said unto me, these be they that have put off the mortal clothing and put on the immortal clothing. Now, even that part right there, you have to break down a little bit. It says that they took off the mortal clothing, you know what? They gave up the flesh of this, they gave up the lust of this world. You know, the lust of this world, whether it be the lust of the eyes, you don't want, you know, trying to sell your soul for a new car or for a better way of living. You know, meaning, and when I say a better way of living, I mean, you know, like to live like one of these rappers or one of these celebrities, you know, to have all the fame, to have all the money, to have all the substance in the world, you know, to commit adultery, to just bang out random chicks, you know, regardless if they have a man or not, you know, just anything that's, you know, sinful, or anything that has to do with the flesh or the externalness of this world. Basically, you know, they put all that aside, and it says, and put on the immortal clothing. Now, what does that mean? That means that they had a what you would call a single vision, a single Salakia, what's the word I'm trying to look for? Basically, they had tunnel vision, is what I was trying to say. You know, their whole mindset and their soul and their mind was basically focused on the kingdom. You know, the kingdom that is to come, the spirit of Yahweh, Shem Yahweh Shah, to be the ruling class of the next government that will be established through the spirit of Yahweh, Shem Yahweh Shah, which is basically to be part of the elect, to rule your own planet, to, you know, create your own elements, you know, just to live in paradise and righteousness. So they put that, so they put on the immortal clothing. It says, and have confessed the name of God. And confess the name of God. Now are they crowned and receive some. So basically, one of the main things is to confess the name of Yahweh Shah. To being part of the elect, one of the main things is to confess that name. But let's continue on to get to the point. It says, now are they crowned and receive psalms. Verse 46, then said I unto the angel, what young person is it that crowneth them and giveth them psalms in their hands? So verse 47, which is the main point. It says, so he answered and said unto me, it is the Son of God whom they have confessed in the world. Then began I greatly to commend them that stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord. So that's the main point. You know, let's read that again for people that didn't really understand the magnitude. It says, then began I greatly to commend them that stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord. So this whole thing is about the name. And you have this demon, Nate, that's trying to take you away from the name and telling you that his name is Jesus Christ, which it is not. There's no way that his name could be Jesus Christ if the letter J didn't come about to the 1600s. To understand the Old Testament, you have to understand the Hebrew, which means at that time it was in Hebrew. So his name will be translated to the original tongue, which would be in the Hebrew, which means his name is Yahweh Shah. And the Heavenly Father's name is Yahweh. So it's Yahweh Wah Yahweh Shah. So you have this demon that constantly is pushing out that the name of the Lord is Jesus, which I can't even stand saying that, but due edification, I have to say that right now, and tell you that you don't need to know the Hebrew, which is false and which is wrong. And at the same time, he's being a hypocrite. Because for whatever reason, whether he sold out for that Judas purse or for whatever demon is controlling him right now, he's constantly throughout all the years telling people not to confess the name of Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shah. When you have countless accounts of him years and years before that, where he used to confess the name, and now he makes a mockery of the name. But let's go into this word stiffly. Because we have that. Because one thing about us, we analyze words. We have to go into this word stiffly. So when you go into the etymology of the word stiffly, it says rigid. It says inflexible. Right. So in this thing, you can't be flexible, man. You know, you have to be persuaded in your own mind, as the scriptures would say, and you have to have that tunnel vision. Like a good example would be to think about like a tree. You know, a tree when it's extremely rooted, it doesn't move. You know, that's why, like the scripture of Colossians 2:7 says, be rooted and built up in the faith. And to even have that name or know that name is to have faith in the name. So you have to be rooted and you have to be built up. So when you look at a tree, the roots are usually three times bigger and pushed down into the soil than the actual tree that you see. So the tree that you see, the roots usually go down three times that same size. So any tree that's extremely, extremely rooted, it doesn't matter if there's 148-mile winds. Guess what? That tree is not going to move. And that's how you need to be in this truth. Once you have that name, you have to be rooted in that name. You can't move by any other winds of doctrine. You can't move by anything. I don't care what anybody tells you. Once you have that name, you have to stay on that name. You have to be 100, a million percent confident in that name. And Nate in IUIC and his followers, his demons, are trying constantly to take the name of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shah out of Yasha'Allah, which is Israel. He is constantly trying to push out that vibration that the name of the Lord is Jesus when it's not. It's Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shah. But I just wanted to bring out that quick point that to be saved, you need the name of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shah. Also, it also says in that scripture, commend. So Esdras was also said that he commended them. When you go into the etymology of the word commend, it says agreeable. It says praises. So he was giving praises to these 144,000 that throughout everything that they had to go through in life, through all the trials and tribulations, you know, through all the deaths, through all the pain, through everything they had to suffer, through the time of Jacob trouble, you know, to come back lifetime after lifetime, you know, and not budge. You know, he commended them, man. He gave them praises. You know, he gave them more praises than just even seeing an angel. Because mind you, he saw that he was talking to an angel. You know, I think any one of us, if we actually knew we was talking to an actual angel, we would be elated. We'd be ecstatic. He forgot all about the angel. Said, yo, I commend these men right here for all that they went through. You know, which in turn, as we know, he also was commending himself because we know he's part of the elect. The spirit of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shah. But still, you know, he gave them praises, man. You know, saying, wow, like how could they do that throughout everything to give up, you know, their kids, you know, their family, their life, you know, the lust of this life, basically just have unwavering faith, you know, unto death. He commended them, man. You know? Now, I'm gonna play a few clips right now. And again, I'm gonna let your mind wander and see what do you think about this situation. Because once you really understand that he's a hypocrite and he's a demon, you know, I'm gonna leave it to you to decide. You think he's still a person that you should be following for all you people out there that are still following this man named Nathaniel, or as we call him, Nate Satan. And we will show videos proving that he has confessed that name in the past, that he know that's the name of the Heavenly Father, but now he continues to mock it.
And don't let nobody child be sick and go, well, brother, and you go into the Greek. If you notice, every doctrine has to go to another language.
Exactly.
They cannot ever explain their doctrine in English. Now, exactly. They're going to the Paleo Hebrew, brother. Paleo.
Exactly.
So now, go to the Hebrew and read what you just read.
And don't let nobody child be sick and go, well, brother, and you go into the Greek. If you notice, every doctrine has to go to another language.
Exactly.
They cannot ever explain their doctrine in English. Now, exactly. They're going to the Paleo Hebrew, brother. Paleo.
Exactly.
So now, go to the Hebrew and read what you just read. 13, you read from 13 to 15. Read it in the Hebrew, okay?
And don't let nobody child be sick and go, well, brother, and you go into the Greek. If you notice, every doctrine has to go to another language.
Exactly.
They cannot ever explain their doctrine in English. Now, exactly. They're going to the Paleo Hebrew, brother. Paleo.
Exactly. Watch out for slick talking brothers like that.
So now, go to the Hebrew and read what you just read. 13, you read from 13 to 15. Read it in the Hebrew.
In the Greek, in the Latin, in the Hebrew. Ebonics.
So now, go to the Hebrew and read what you just read, 13, you read from 13 to 15. Read it in the Hebrew.
You see that? And commended them for those that stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord. What is it talking about that we stood stiffly for the name of the Lord? Reuben. Because a Negro will jump up and go, Yahweh!
They have their father's name written in their minds. Yahweh. So we're the ones calling on the name of the Lord. Read. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? So, but how can you call on the name of the Lord if you have not believed on the Lord, the true Lord of that the Bible is talking about?
If niggas call Israelites, don't be fooled by that. That's why I scorn when I hear somebody say Yahweh. As soon as I hear it, I know it's spirit of evil is there. I've not seen one righteous man use that term, not one. Every one of them, evil, malice, guile, gossip, every last one of them. Okay, give me Acts 13. I'm going to take it down.
Yahweh, that's the name. When it says Lord God in the English, that's the name right there. Yahweh, the four characters that, like I showed you earlier, 1 second, we're going to go back to that. This is what you're reading in the Hebrew, the Yahweh, the tetragram derived from that. Yahweh. So we're the ones calling on the name of the Lord. Read. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? So, but how can you call on the name of the Lord if you have not believed on the Lord, the true Lord of that the Bible's talking about? Okay?
About a black man.
We found out who's going to be saved, who's going to be calling on the name of the Lord. 144,000 of the nation of Israel. They have their father's name written in their minds. Yahweh. So we're the ones calling on the name of the Lord. Read. Okay, one kingdom. Okay, so now when we go out and we're teaching you, you must call on the name of the Lord, Yahweh, in truth, in spirit and in truth. Go ahead. And I was blessed then. So it was a law for the Israelites to use and put the name of Yahweh upon one another. The priest would do that, okay? So you're supposed to pray in the name of Yahweh. Pray to Yahweh, you Israelites. But for you others that are not Israelites, don't use that name. The white man understands that. That's why he said, we better not play with that. Let's not use that name. Because why? Because he knows destruction is not far behind. You got all these different consents out here. You got one group calling him Jehovah. Another group of our people calling him Yahweh. Another group calling him Yahweh. Another group of our people saying Allah. Another group of our people saying Yahweh. That's madness. That's not what one consent. Because you have not sat down and studied and researched the name of the Lord, which we have, and discovered that his name is Yahweh. The Most High revealed it to us, okay, that his true name is Yahweh. You must all come under that name, all you Israelites. You must call on the name of the Lord with one consent. His son, Christ, as you call him. Read. Who has gathered the wind in his fist? Who has gathered the wind in his fist? The Father. Go ahead. Who has bound the waters in a garment? Who has bound the waters in a garment? The Father, whose name is Yahweh, as we've proved. Go ahead. Who have established all the ends of the earth? Who has established all the ends of the earth? The Father, Yahweh. Go ahead. What is his name? What is his name? It's Yahweh. That's his name. Yahweh. Read. And what is his son's name? Now, this is the topic we're getting into now. And what is his son's name? If thou canst tell. If thou canst tell. Have you researched? Okay, we're going to prove the name of the son now. The name of the son is Yahweh Shah. 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 Okay. So in Acts chapter 7, verse 45, instead of Joshua, the scholars inserted the name Jesus. And in Hebrew, they have it translated Yahweh Shah. Okay?
with these characters here, which is pronounced Yahweh Shai. That's how you pronounce the name here. This is what's in Acts chapter 7, verse 45. Okay? You have the Yah, Ha, Wah, Shah, and the I sound here, pronounced Yahweh Shai. That's in Acts 7, verse 45. However, in Matthew chapter 1, verse 21, they have Jesus translated Yahshua. Okay? As you see here, Yahshua. So now you have two different names for the name Jesus. Which one is the correct translation? Let's go to Hebrews chapter 4 and verse 8. Okay? His name is Yahweh. Okay, as we proved, Yahweh is the Father's name, meaning He is. So now, the angel told Joseph that the name of the Messiah would mean He saves, or He would save His people. So, the meaning is different. So in Exodus, when it says, my name is in Him, it means the sound of the Father's name is in the name of Christ. So now, let's look at the two names we've discovered for Jesus. Let's look once again in Matthew 1:21, where it said Jesus, it said Yahshua. The Father's name, the sound of the Father's name is not in that. Yahshua means He saves. When we went to Acts 7 and 45, the scholars translated the name Jesus Yahweh Shai, just like in Hebrews 4 and 8. Is the name Yahweh, the sound, is that sound in the name Yahweh Shai? Yes. Yes, it is. Yahweh Shai.
And not only does he even mock it, he mocks it so much to the point that he actually makes it seem as if, you know, that name came down from the heaven and hit a rock. And he just stumbled upon it. And then made even mockery of this situation.
Brothers! Come, I can't believe what I saw. Come on, I cannot believe it. Whoa,
I cannot believe this.
Looks like it's been there for hundreds of years.
This has been there for hundreds of years. Hundreds. Come look. Oh my goodness.
Oh no.
Say,
you okay?
No.
You all right, Evan?
No, I think I was wrong. This has been here for 500 years. See, that says Yahweh Wah, Yahweh Shah. Oh God.
It's a great discovery.
Does this mean we gotta go join the bum camp?
No. We don't join the bum camp. That just means God is part of the tribe.
Yeah, God is part of the tribes. Oh man. That's gonna be good. You are not to be, it was never, his name was never used. Every time you see a brother, invoke his name, put the name. That's what Negroes do. That's why the Most High said, you know what? In the kingdom, I'm gonna give him my true name. Because look how they do my name.
Because we grew up, the Father's name to us, we were taught is Yahweh.
Well, this has been here for 500 years. See, that says, Yahweh Wah, Yahweh Shah. Oh God. Look how they do my name.
It's a great discovery.
Does this mean we gotta go join the bum camp?
No. We don't join the bum camp.
So with that being said, I push this question upon you, and it's just a question. Do you think from what we've seen, what we've been seeing right now, we don't know about what's going to happen in the future, but from right now, do you think that Ezra, so I pose this question upon you, do you think, and we're talking about from right now, we don't know what's going to happen in the future, but from this standpoint right now, from what we've been seeing going on, do you think that Ezra's seen IUIC and Nate Satan in the vision? And with that being said, Hopefully this was edifying for you brothers that constantly follow Nate Sands' camp. And for you brothers out there that's in this truth and doing the will of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shah, I'd like to give infinity honors to Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shah, double honors to the Apostle GMS, and salutations to the elect and all you other brothers out there doing this work in truth and sincerity. And Lord willing, to the next time, Shalom.